bring some objects.
Yeah, if anybody brought anything special you want to share, please bring it up and place it on the table. And why do that?
It could be anything of significance. It doesn't have to be something
that's
antique.
Old,
it could be something that has a special memory to you, something that someone gave you, someone that has an interesting history.
While you guys do that, I'm going to play a little piece on Abigail. Abigail's the oldest instrument that I have in my meager collection. She's 350 years old, and sometimes she goes places other violins don't, so.
And please don't be shy. We won't. Paul and I, the impetus behind the musical seance is Paul and I enjoy channeling music on our own, just composing on the spot in front of an audience. And then I decided to take it one step further, and I said, well, what if we involve the audience and how beautiful to bring their energy into it and things that are meaningful to them, and we channel music together but through the audience. So it's turned into the musical seance, and if you didn't bring an object, or you don't want to leave it up on the table, because we do sell this on eBay after the show. If you don't want to, I would like you to concentrate on something that's meaningful to you, or a wish, or someone that you care deeply about, so we can just like have that energy united with everyone in the room. But I think tonight we should have an audience member choose the object.
Yeah.
So we're just making it very cyclical. The gal in the pink hair, because I had a nice conversation with her yesterday. If you want to come up,
if you'd like
pick
to come
something
up here,
that's speaking to you.
Just pick something that you think is really cool. And you're spooky.
Okay, do you want to hold that up so you can... And then we can ask who brought this object. And the lady in the front row. So tell us about this particular object.
I've always had a very big thing about clocks. And it has an old staff, like scepter on it. And on the bottom of it, connected to it, is a clock. And I have no idea what the significance of the time on the clock is. But I just love the look of it, I love old.
Now, who's a graphic designer? Because isn't it true in graphic design that you're supposed to always make a clock at 10:10 because it resembles a smile and uplifting? You never want to make it like 8:20 or something, you know, it's down. But yeah, I just heard from graphic design that it's always 10:10. Or in my world, it should always be 11:11. All right, something for the clock?
We're all waiting for something.
Thank you.
It's one of those that's always looking right at you.
Someone that takes the effort to haul a painting to a crowded convention must have a story. And who's the